Hi everyone, and welcome to the next lesson in this series on AWS Fundamentals. So today I'm going to be teaching you as to how you can go ahead and provision your own SSL or TLS certificate in Amazon Certificate Manager, and how to attach this SSL certificate to your domain. Okay, so we're going to use two services today, and I've attached them here on our navigation bar. So we need to use Route 53. So I went ahead and just attached it to the navigation bar. And Route 53 is a service, if you don't already know, that is used to register our domain name and also acts as a DNS. It's basically the place where we configure all of our DNS records and whatnot. And the second service that we'll be using is called Amazon Certificate Manager. So you can just type in Certificate Manager. Certificate Manager. And of course, as it says here, it is used to provision, manage, and deploy SSL or TLS certificates. So be sure to just attach those to your navigation bar. Okay, so the first thing I want you guys to make sure is if you click on Route 53 here, let's open it up, is I want you guys to make sure that you actually have a domain name registered here. So make sure that you have a domain name. So if we click on domain, okay, I have one here that's called edensort.com. So make sure you've registered a domain name. If you're unsure of how to do this, I did make a video earlier on how to register a domain name on AWS. So make sure you check out that video before you follow this video here. Okay, so make sure you have your domain name from Route 53. That's the first thing that you need to make sure. Okay, so that's it. So we have our domain name. And if we click on hosted zone, okay, if you've been following, you should only have two records, okay? And these are the default records that we get whenever we create a domain name or register a domain name in AWS. Okay, so these will be the default NSN SOA records. So don't mess around with them, just leave it as it is. So generally speaking, whenever you create a domain name, it will automatically create a hosted zone, as we can see here, for our domain name. Okay, so do bear that in mind. Okay, so now comes the exciting part. So we're going to now open Certificate Manager here. So AWS Certificate Manager. So we can go ahead and say request a certificate. And I just want to say this right off the bat, SSL certificates are free, okay? So you don't need to worry about any costs related to this. So it's free, so don't worry. Okay, so we are going to go ahead and request a public certificate. There's no need for a private one. So we can just say request a public certificate. And we can just say next. Okay, now go ahead and put in your domain name. Now, I want to give you a bit of advice here. So AWS actually gives us advice. So you can see here, it says that we can add additional names to our SSL certificate. So as it says here, if we are requesting a certificate for www.example.com, we can go ahead and add something such as example.com. So basically, okay, if you have your domain name, so mine, for example, it's called edensort.com. Okay, yours can be, let's say, mywebsite.com. Okay, so that would be your domain name. When you set up your SSL certificate, very important, okay, you cannot like edit this after you've set it. So my first suggestion is to just go ahead and put in your normal domain name. So in my case, it's edensort.com. Just now put in your domain name. Okay, and then make sure you add another name to this SSL certificate. And I always like to go ahead and say www.mydomainname.com. So very important. This is probably the most important part of this whole process, because this is also important when you are configuring your web applications and whatnot. It's going to need to be aware of what are the domain names attached to your SSL certificate. So this is such an important step. So make sure that you add in two variants of your domain name. One, which is the domain name that you see here, which is the default one. And then make sure you add www. And then followed by your domain name. Very important. So basically, these are the two variants that your customers, clients, or whatnot will be able to access your website at. And what I mean by that is if they were to go to the URL, they can either type in, for example, in my case, edensort.com, or they can type in www.edensort.com to get to the website. So this is what I mean by that. Okay, so bear that in mind. So remember, two variants of your domain name, very important. Okay, so validation method. So it's recommended to use DNS validation. I use this myself. It is a better way to do it. But just for this tutorial, just to keep it very easy and simple for you, okay, I'm going to go and choose email validation. Okay, so go ahead and choose this option. Then you just want to say request, all right? Okay, so a request has been sent. Okay, and we can click on our certificate here, so it's pending validation. Okay, so it's taking some time here. So basically what's going to happen is you're going to receive a few emails. I'm not sure. It's usually going to be at least two emails. You can get more. Okay, and you need to approve the request for these two domain names. Okay, right. So it can take up to about 15, 20 minutes to receive these emails. So don't be alarmed if you don't get them. Okay, so just give it some time and just wait, and then it will come to your email. Usually it will be in your spam. So please be aware of that. So it will usually be in your spam. So make sure you check your spam. And what you can do is you can go ahead and remove it from spam so that it goes to your main inbox. Okay, but I will help you through that. So let's just wait. And then we'll move on to the next set of steps. Okay, so let's just wait for that. Hi, everyone, and welcome back. So as I can see now, I have two emails from AWS on Amazon Certificate Manager. So these were originally in my spam, so make sure that you check your spam. And all I did was I simply moved it to my inbox here. So let's click on the first one here. And we can see here, okay, this one is for www.edensalt.com. Okay, and let's check the next one. This one is for edensalt.com. So we have two emails here for our two domain name variants. Okay, so do be aware they can be more than two emails sent to you. This really depends on AWS with how they feel about things. But let's just go ahead and try it out and see how it goes. So let's choose the first one, so www.edensalt.com. We want to click on this huge and massive link here, so go ahead and click on that. Okay, this is fine. And open that up, and what we can do is we can actually go ahead and validate this. So just go ahead and say I approve. Perfect. So we can close that up, and now what we can do is we can go to the second email that we have here. So I'm going to pretend I just opened it. Let's go here, and this one is for edensalt.com, the original variant. So we can scroll down, open this up in another tab, and we can just go ahead and approve it. Perfect. Done. Okay, so we got that done. Now what we can do now is we can go to AWS Certificate Manager, and what we can do is just refresh the page here. So just refresh it. Okay, we can see it's issued, and there we go. So edensalt.com and www.edensalt.com, both these domain variants, okay, have been attached to our SSL certificate, so it's now provisioned. We can go to certificates here, and we can now see that we've provisioned successfully our SSL certificate for the following domain, edensalt.com, in my case. Okay, so that's it, guys. Short and sweet for you guys. So this is how we would do it via email validation. So do bear in mind there are chances that you can receive multiple emails for your domains to verify. In our case, we only received two. One for the one domain and one for the other domain. Okay, so just remember, I don't want you to get confused, that these two domains here are attached to this domain as the SSL certificate. So don't be confused by that. This is just how it works in this way. Okay, so that's it, guys. I hope to help you. And yeah, that's it. So thank you very much. And yeah, all the best. Thank you guys for the support as always. And yeah, thank you guys. See you.